to you all and welcome again to another talk on the Blessed on YouTube channel. Today I want to talk about something that I felt that is really important that we take note of it, and maybe going into the year 2020 that something different needs to happen, that a different approach needs to be taken. And what I'm talking about is nothing other than the refusal or the inability of Nigerian representatives to the CAF, that is the Confederation of African Football, to vote for their own compatriot, Asisat Oshoala. And she was going to be the African Footballer of the Year in the female capacity, but none of the Nigerians voted for her. There were five of them, none of them voted for her. I think this is outrageous. This is something to condemn. And especially when you see how we live here in the diaspora and everybody is just doing their own thing and nobody wants to associate with fellow Nigerians, because when you do, it's like you are kind of dipping your hands into fire. There is so much competition, what we call bad belly envy, like na me go first hammer, na me want first go prove myself for us. There are so many sentiments to it. I feel that this is really, really wrong. And if we can be doing something like this to ourselves, how much more? What right do we have to say Europeans or Germans or Americans that they did something like this to us, or the British that they did not see the merit in us and that they overlook us to choose somebody else because of our skin color, because of our ethnicity? All these kind of things, we do worse to ourselves. How can it be that five representatives that were sent to the CAF by Nigeria, the NFF representative, Nigerian Football Association, what are they called? NFF, no? Nigerian Football Federation. And none of them thought it meritable for Oshoala to be voted. And now she has won the African Footballer of the Year female capacity, and they are now sending in their stupid, silly congratulations. But it was in their hands to make it possible, that, but they don't see the good in themselves, you see. And now somebody is going to come and say, oh, we voted on merit, we were there as represented as professionals, we don't want to vote according to our ethnicity. So you couldn't see the goodness, the excellence, the meritocracy crazy that she merited in being so excellent in what she does, but you can see that one in another people. So it will take other Africans to see the goodness in the skills that Oshoala represents. Is this not something for them to be ashamed of? I am ashamed on their behalf. So NFF representatives, all of you that refuse to vote for your fellow Nigerians, do not come and complain about how anybody else has treated you unfairly. Do not come and complain how anybody sidelined you, because your karma is going to come. Because it's really, really, really very bad of you to not see anything good in your fellow Nigerian. You know that when we are in Nigeria, we are talking about being Igbo, being Yoruba, being Hausa, being Edo, but when you are in the diaspora, when you come outside of Nigeria, nobody knows any of those things. Nobody cares. Even if you are black, you are black. Even to the point that you are just black globally, nobody cares whatever your ethnic makeup is. And still, the Nigerians, they cannot see into this. They cannot even understand this thing, that this is how the world sees you. They don't see differences in you. You should see yourself as the world is seeing you when you are outside of Africa. And you should be able to be the help, the climbing stone, the motivator, anything that you can do to help somebody to achieve their goals. Because Oshoala, she is so good. She has worked so hard and she is doing very well in her field of football. She's, you know, with Barcelona Football Federation. So let's keep it straight and keep it real, because Oshoala is good. It's not like when you are voting for her, you are just kind of making your vote irrelevant, or that you are just being, what's the word for it, nepotic, but you are doing something just to enhance her chances, because she has done the rest. She's working hard. She's a very good footballer. She's with Barcelona Football Corporation or something like that. Yeah, so it's not anybody that will go to Barcelona, but she made it there. So she didn't need your vote to go there. She worked hard for it and she merited it and she got there. So this is in extension telling fellow Nigerians, be of help, be of use to your fellow Nigerians when you are abroad. Do not be the stumbling block to their glory. Do what you have to do to help them, and let us even help ourselves, because here, when you are abroad, all your struggles, no Nigerian wants to come close to you. When you are having problems, they will just look at you. Maybe you are passing the same process they have passed through, but they could have helped you with one tip or the other. They will just be looking at you. And maybe you are having problem with accommodation or anything. Nobody wants to help each other because of lack of gratitude. Maybe there are other reasons, but I think that at some point we really need to start making a change. And I hope that this 2020, being a new decade, being the beginning of another year, let us really do something to change the narrative, to start a new leaf. And if we see a fellow Nigerian in any capacity that needs just a little thing that will not involve too much of our involvement, we can do that. As little something as voting. Just vote, yeah. Vote and accentuate that propensity for her to win. It's not going to cost you anything, you know? So I just feel like saying this thing because I think it's really a shame, and I think they should really have a rethink of what they did, and they should not repeat it going forward. Yeah, so this is what I want to share with you in this video. It's not a very long video, and I hope that you subscribe to my channel if you're coming here for the first time. When you do subscribe, do hit that notification bell so you get to know when I upload a new video. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon in another video. Bye bye.